Churchianity versus Christianity. When a genuine Christian happens to find himself settled down as a clergyman of the Church of England in addition to the troublesome memories of the inconvenient declarations by which he reached his position, he must frequently be the victim of mental nausea at the sight of the motley squadron in which he is enrolled. There is good Mr. Ryle, an indefatigable tractarian, who hates Romish tractarianism, and preaches the gospel thoroughly, and there are many, like him, the excellent of the earth, distinguished for piety, who would be an honor to any denomination of Christians. A believer in Jesus feels much comfort in such company, but who are those spirits in red, white, and blue? Aliens from the Commonwealth of Israel, in their dress at any rate. Their voice is Babylonian even as their apparel. They hail from Rome, and are affectionately attached to the mother of harlots. Can the lover of truth go with these? Can the believer in the Lord Jesus Christ's pure gospel sit in the same congress with these priests? Bow at the same altar? Unite in church fellowship with them? Surely the more gracious a man is, the more irksome must such fellowship become. That searching question, what concord hath Christ with Belial, if it ever intrudes itself into rectories, must torture any evangelical clergyman who keeps a tender conscience. Moreover, on the other side of the quadrangle of the establishment, one sees a Philistine regiment of skeptics, with a bishop to head them, and all sorts of dignitaries to make up the battalion. Can the spiritual mind find peace in an affinity with these? Can it be to the evangelical clergyman, who is truly converted, a fact to sleep quietly upon, that he is in full communion with these unbelievers? The apostolical inquiry, what part hath he that believeth with an infidel, must surely at times ring through the manse, and startle the quiet of the vicarage library. How our brethren manage to read the burial service?